and welcome to the 13th episode of my paint and pigment making series. This isn't really a natural organic pigment, but to be totally honest, those are becoming a bit of a headache right now. So this time, I'm going to make paint out of something stable and predictable, copper carbonate. One of you recommended this to me, and although I would have liked to make it from scratch, I'm way too self-aware of my abilities, so I'm sorry to say I took the easy route and just bought the powder ready-made. If you want a good tutorial on how it's made though, I'll leave a link or two in the description. I got my copper carbonate from a ceramic store that sells glazes and slips, and it was really, really cheap, at least where I live, so I'm excited to see how good of a paint this turns out to be. It's used in so many things, ranging from jewelry, fertilizers, fireworks, to paints and glaze, so it shouldn't be too difficult to find it wherever you are. I will also link to some in the description below. Also, since this is a synthetic pigment, it's super important to take a look at its material safety data sheet. Some synthetic pigments are extremely toxic and nobody should ever take a risk like that. So taking a few seconds to look through these keeps you safe, but also gives you useful information such as solubility. For example, it says here that copper carbonate is insoluble in water, so you wouldn't want to use it as a dye or ink, and that'll just save you a lot of time. As for safety, it's not too dangerous, but it can be irritating to the eye, skin, and lungs. If you work with it regularly or in large quantities, you should wear protection, but since this is a one-off, I'm just going to be careful not to agitate it and make it go in the air. It's super important though that you don't pour it down the drain since it's toxic to some fish and algae. Now that that's out of the way, I start as usual by placing my pigment on a glass slab that has been rubbed with sandpaper, and since this pigment is so pretty, it's getting the macro treatment. I usually use walnut alkyd, but today I'm switching that up to walnut oil because this channel is full of plot twists. Gotta keep it fresh, you know? Honestly, this paint is so pleasant, easy, and relaxing to mull. I really get why synthetic pigments beat out the plant-based ones. It's such a pretty color, it makes an incredibly fine and smooth paint. I'm just really enjoying this one a lot, you have no idea. No stress, no surprises, no disappointments, just easy, good paint. I make a few test swatches on a blank piece of canvas. Since I know that this paint isn't affected by UV light or oxidization, I won't make any color and light fastness tests. I paint a swatch of the paint by itself with no additives. Unfortunately, cameras have a kind of dulling effect and can't really show how vivid some colors are, but this one is quite bright and strong in real life. Next swatch is the copper carbonate with titanium white paint. And to be honest, it's not the most pigmented since only a little bit of white washed it out dramatically. It's still a very, very pretty pastel color. In the end, not much to say there except that this one was a pretty solid success, and it feels pretty good. I hope you enjoyed this paint as much as I enjoyed making it, and please remember to leave comments, questions, or suggestions down below. I really love reading and replying to them since this is such a niche topic. As always, thanks for watching!
Thank you.